Hey, my name is Dr. Sean Price, clinical director here at The Fix in Fort Walton Beach, and this is video number 3 in our series on the thyroid pathway and what is actually going on in your body if you're dealing with symptoms of low thyroid. So what happens here, we've talked about the metabolic pathway, we've talked about the beginning phases of this, how medicine fits into it, where synthroid armor and things like that go into. So in this video, we're going to explain how that's a very short-sighted view. If you did not watch video 2, please go back and watch that video because it's not going to make sense for us moving forward unless you understand what we talked about in the last video. Okay, so thyroid gland makes T4 and T3. Now here's the key. T4 is about 93% of what the thyroid makes. T3 is about 7% of what the thyroid makes. Now why is that important? Because T4 is inactive. So let's say that you want to make yourself a cup of coffee. And you went over to the coffee maker and you took out a bunch of coffee beans, put them into your coffee filter, put it in there, ran the hot water over the coffee beans. You're going to get some brownish water, but you're not going to get coffee. Those coffee beans need to be processed. Okay, that's what T4 is. T4 is not usable by the body. T3 is the active form. So the thyroid in and of itself up to this point only makes about 7% of the active T3 that then goes on and is used by the cells or used for reverse T3 or whatever process, but this is the only thing that thyroid gland makes. T4 has to be processed. Basically, the body has to go in and cleave one of the iodines off of that T4 to turn it into T3. So how does it do that? T4 gets onto thyroid binding globulin. It's kind of like a taxi cab. Thyroid binding globulin carries T4 out to the liver, to the gut, to the kidneys, and all the other tissues in the body. Now, the reason I say all the other tissues in the body is every single cell in the body has a T3 receptor, okay? So, has a thyroid receptor. So, it's very important that this process happens and this gets out to all the cells. So, if you have a breakdown, something blocking T4 from getting onto thyroid binding globulin, you're not going to have normal thyroid metabolism. Because once this processing happens, this is where T4 is converted into T3. So in essence, this is where we get 93% of our T3. Then that T3 goes in and is used by a reverse T3. It gets into the cell, assuming that there are the proper nutrients to get that T3 into the cell. That's where the majority of metabolism happens. Now in the last video, I explained to you that medication and the medical model and the testing that's typically done stops right here. It addresses none of this. So you can be totally normal up to this point, but if that T4 cannot get over here and convert into T3, you're going to have some level of this 93% of your thyroid metabolic output is going to be affected, and you're going to have hypothyroid symptoms. Okay, I hope that makes sense because it's very, very critical that you understand this. Now, in the rest of the videos, we're going to break this down a little bit further, but it's very important that you understand that this point on is where we find the majority of our problems in our patient. It has nothing to do with the thyroid gland. Even in a situation like Hashimoto's, which you'll understand in one of the next videos, even in that situation, that's not necessarily a thyroid issue. It's a breakdown somewhere downstream, okay? So we're gonna get further into this on the next video. If you have any questions, please feel free to post below, and we'll see you on the next video.